Okay, magandang hapon sa inyong lahat. We are live here at the Elorde Sports Center for Elorde International Productions, Night of Champions 32. This is Rica, Baby Dynamite Aquino. Ako po ang inyong commentator for today sa ating event.
Before we start the fight, we would like to acknowledge, of course, the presence of the Games and Amusement Board Chairman Attorney Richard Clarion. Also on the ring side, the Chief of Boxing, Jackie Katcher. And also I'd like to thank at ringside promoter, Gabriel Bebon Elorde Jr. Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon and welcome to the Sports Center at the Flash Grand Ballroom. And today we're proud to present the Night of Champions 32, presented to you by Elorde International Productions promoter Gabriel Bebon Elorde Jr. Ladies and gentlemen, all professional bouts are sanctioned by the Games and Amusement Board Chairman Attorney Richard Clarion and the Chief of Boxing Jackie Cacho Ornido. And sponsored by Fairtex, your official gloves for champions, Elorde Sports and Tourism Development Corporation, Elorde TV, Pinterest for your hand painting pots, Glenford Brips, and Elorde Gym Festival Mall. And now, ladies and gentlemen, this bout is scheduled for 4 rounds in the lightweight division. The 3 judges at ringside scoring this bout on a 10-point mount system will be Carlo Baloyo, Giorgio Iannella, and Robert Bridges. And when the bell rings, your referee in charge of the action, Don Arguelles. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing first, fighting out the blue corner, wearing white with yellow trim and weighing 135 pounds, professional record, 1 win, no loss. From Majestic Boxing Gym, Makati City, introducing Jaime Patago. And his opponent across the ring, fighting out the red corner, wearing black with gray and weighing 136 pounds, professional record, 4 wins, no defeat. From Elorde Fight Team, Paranaque City, ladies and gentlemen, Donald Larejas.
Okay, here we go, the first bout of the day. Welcome sa inyong lahat. Maraming salamat sa panonood dito sa Elorde TV. Again, you are watching Night of Champions 32. We have 4 bouts for you today. Short but sweet fight card. We have a double main event. And ang unang bout natin ngayon, of course, is Donald Larejas versus Jairik Patago. Larejas is from the Elorde Fight Team. And Jairik Patago is from Majestic Boxing Gym. Okay, mahina pa rin po ba ang audio? Please comment lang po if naririnig ninyo ako. Shout out kay Filomeno Abangona from Hingog City. Okay, early start, early fireworks from Larejas. Si Larejas ay nagbabalik sa ring ngayon matapos ang ilang buwan din na hindi siya nakapaglaro. His last fight was in March 25. It was against Dexter Iraya. At ito namang si Jairik Patago, no? Oh! There you have it. Huwag kang kukurap. And the moment na kumarok pa ko, ayan na nga, ano? A shot that sent down a Jairik Patago down the canvas. Laurejas leading with that jab, a counter straight by Patago. Body shots from Laurejas. Patago miss with that hook. Stays inside the pocket. Blocks the punches from Laurejas. Answers with an uppercut to the body. Again, sa mga hindi naka-witness, ano, nagkaroon ng knockdown early in this round. Laurejas. Oop, a hook to the head by Laurejas and hook to the body. Both of these boxers are undefeated. Ano? Laurejas with a record of 4-0. Ito namang si Patago has a record of 1 win and 0 loss. Body shot for body shot. Oh, that hook landed flush on Patago. Patago with that straight. Laurejas answers with the 5-6 punches. Body shots by Patago. Peppering the body of Laurejas with those body shots. Trying to soften his guard. Oh, a straight. That landed flush for Patago. Another straight, but Laurejas with that quick counter, with that two-punch counter. Ay, shout out sa aking classmate, ang isa sa mga pinakamagigiting na international referee natin, Gerald Tomeldanes, watching us. There you have it. What an interesting round, ano. Donald Laurejas always moves in with a combination, 3-4 punches. I like how he leads with body shots and then goes to the head. Ito namang si Patago, quick to counter. I like his straight. Just a quick rundown of that round. Nagkaroon ng knockdown against Patago. Patango was sent down the canvas. But he was able to get up and was able to put up a good fight against Donald Laurejas. Ano? Again, welcome everybody na nanonood. Kitty May Glines, ay rooting for Donald. Here we go. Round two. Donald Laurejas is wearing the Be Athletic black and white trunks. Ito namang si Jairik Patago is wearing the white and yellow trunks. Body shot by Patago and a straight. Laurejas with that quick left hook counter. Another quick left hook counter. Wow. The punch resistance of Patago is something, because that was an explosive hook by Laurejas. Again, you are watching the 32nd Night of Champions dito lamang po sa Elorde Ballroom. You are going to witness 4 fights and of course, two main event fights. Unang-una, yung PBF Lightweight Championship. And then the second one is for the youth featherweight title, ano? Again, those body shots by Laurejas. Oh, but actually, itong si Patago has a very sharp, long-range uppercut din, ano? Oh, a hook that landed for Patago. 1, 2, 3, 4 punch combinations that ended with a body shot for Laurejas. A missed overhand by Patago. Please let me know, guys, if you can hear the audio clearly. Wow, dumadami na ang mga tao dito ngayon sa Ilorde Grand Ballroom. Sa pagkakaalam ninyo lamang, ito ay libre. So, libre kayong manonood dito ng live. Kung hindi naman, ay pwede kayong manood sa Ilorde TV. Ayan na nga, i-share ninyo itong video na ito. Body shots to body shots by Patago Laurejas. Oh, with that hook counter. Another hook, but this time a right hook by Laurejas. Laurejas with that pressure, no? He's trying to bring in those combinations, stringing those combinations one after the other. I like how he compounds his combination, ano? Oh, body shots naman by Batago. Look at that. He's trying to break the guard of Laurejas. What I like about Patago naman, he's not waiting, no, for an opportunity for Laurejas to open up. He opens up Laurejas with those shots, ano? Again, please like and share this video sa ating double main event for the PBF Lightweight Championship. We have Archiel Villamor Jr. from Ilorde Boxing Gym Santa Rita versus Harry Omak of Ilorde Fight Team Gilmore. And for the vacant Philippine Youth Super Featherweight Championship, we have Rachel Calo versus Joniel Laurente. Calo is also from Ilorde Boxing Gym Santa Rita. Laurente is also from Ilorde Fight Team. So this is gonna be interesting. It's an interesting matchup. They both bear the name Ilorde in their teams, but these are two completely different teams, ano? Here we go, round three. Patago leading with that jab. He is the southpaw in this fight, or siya ang kaliwete. Laurejas is the orthodox. Laurejas moves low, doesn't move outside the pocket. Patago targets the body with that right hand. A hook pivot by Patago. So the first round, ano, just a review. May knockdown against Patago. So certainly that round went to Laurejas. The second round, both of them, it was very competitive. Ano? It can go either way. Certainly after that knockdown, Patago has been more aggressive and more accurate with his shots. Ano? And he's more cautious and more defensive. Doesn't mean that he's... He doesn't move in, ano, or he doesn't engage in exchanges, because as you can see, he is willing to trade with Donald Laurejas. Laurejas again with that body head combination, body movement by Laurejas. He uses that body movement to counter pretty well, ano. I'm speaking about Laurejas. Oh, fast counter by Patago, and then another counter upper by Laurejas. Oh, a ripping body shot by Laurejas. Patago pushes him. Pushes him with that straight to the head and that straight to the body. I like how both of these boxers are just investing on the body. The work rate of these two boxers hasn't gone down in round three. Body shot again from Patago. Upper and hook and upper by Patago. Laurejas moves forward with that jab. Yes po, pasensya na po sa hindi ko na shout out. Nalingat lang tayo ng onte. Arce Basas, maraming salamat. This is just the first fight. Wendell Magsino, shout out from Ilorde Southbox. John Tapo, shout out kong Jojo Vistal. Arce Basas, shout out. Meow, meow. Kubaltud. Shout out din sa iyo at thank you for following Elorde TV. At syempre sa partner natin, partner ng Recalvination, the other half of Recalvination, Sir Alvin Esgo. Namiss ka na daw ni Russell at ni Raymark dito. Sana kung nasan ka man daw ay huwag mo silang kakalimutan. Jonathan Francisco, shout out sa iyo. Watching from Pattaya, Thailand. Good luck daw kay Harry Omak. Kitty Maygline, shout out sa iyo. Watching from Caloocan. Our magaling na boxer from PMI Boxing Stable, Richard Lasponia, nanonood din sa atin. Coach Monit Pabroa, watching us from Binondo. Naku sir, wala po ang other half ng Recalvination ngayon. Si Rika lang po nandito, pero show some love to Sir Alvin by still typing hashtag Recalvination. Last and final round na po natin. Shout out Noel Lawagon from Naawan, Misamis Oriental. Oh, that was a good straight weave and then jab by Batago. Daureas moving forward. He got a little bit off balance right there, but that is a good tight guard from Laurejas. He's able to stay inside the pocket with that high guard. He also weaves and bobs. Oh, and is able to counter with that right hand. Ay, isa pang magaling na boxer to, si Chris Ganoza. Shout out from Elorde San Antonio. And also shout out sa Porres Brothers who are watching us right now. Again from PMI Boxing Stable. Leron Sotib, shout out sa iyo, taga Hingog. Misamis Oriental, napakaganda dyan sa Hingog. Ate Jelly Ariston is also watching. A body shot for a body shot. I like how these two boxers just set to target the body, you know, yung mga body shots nila. The counter straight of Laurejas, body shots. Oh! And another devastating body shot from Donald Laurejas that sent Patago down to the canvas and our referee has called it off. That was the second knockdown, but it's okay. Patago certainly gave a good fight. Sabi ko nga kanina, yung mga counter straight niya is really something. He was able to land some pretty good combinations against Donald, but it was just that. Today is Donald Laurejas' day. Congratulations, Donald Laurejas. Still undefeated with 5 wins and 0 loss. Patago experienced his first loss today, but no shame in that because he put up a good performance kahit na natumba siya nung first round. He stood up, he became more aggressive and more tactical, but yun na nga, ultimately it's the body shots that the ROI of that of Laurejas's body shots paid off in the fourth and final round.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Don Aguilas reaches the count of 10 at 1 minute and 44 seconds of round number 4. We have a winner by knockout, Donald Laurejas.
There you have it, winner via knockout in the fourth round, Donald Laurejas. Chang Lee, shout out sa iyo diyan sa Tanay. Naririnig niyo po ba ako? Sabi ni Ma'am Kitty, hindi daw po ako naririnig. So please comment kung naririnig niyo na ako ngayon. Coach Jover, mga yaay, good luck kay Royder Lloyd Bourbon. Nalaban na, susunod na. Ali Kanyega is also watching us. Mangbubukid ko, Noy. Shout out sa Team Tatcon 2. God bless daw sa ating lahat. Leron Sotib is watching us from Hingoog City and he is rooting for Wesley Caga, the pride of Hingoog. Brian, shout out sa iyo dyan sa Batangas. Oh, okay. Thank you, Sir Tommy Young. Thank you for watching. Sir Tommy Young is such a great boxing analyst and a boxing writer. Yeah, I think Elorde TV is muting the mic here in-house because of the music that's playing. Because the music is can be copyright or will be a copyright violation. So we will be muting the audio in the house. Randy Orbista, shout out, watching from Montalban. Rodriguez Rizal. Randy Orbista, shout out. Gildy Polanco is watching us from New Zealand. Thank you guys for watching. Please share this video. We have an exciting fight card for you guys. We have a double main event. Sir Archiel Villamor Sr., yes po. Ang inyong anak po na si Archiel Villamor Jr. ay pangatlo for today. We just finished the first bout. So isa na lang po ay si Junior na po ang lalaban. Ano po? Pang ilang fight si Wesley? Actually, next na po si Wesley dito. Abangan Filomeno, good luck kay Wesley Caga. Proud Hingoog nun. Sabi ni Heide Patago, it's okay kahit talo. Oo naman, congrats pa din Binbunso. We are proud of you, Jairik. Oo, tama kayo dyan. Maganda ang pinakita ni Jairik today. Kahit nababagsak siya nung first round, he came back with an even better game plan and he's more aggressive. Ano? So ang ganda na pinakita niya. Tapang, diskarte. And ganun naman talaga paglaban, ano, meron talagang panalo, meron talo. Normal yan talaga sa boxing. Sir Roland Bohol is watching us from Vegas. Lana Odala is watching us from Makati. Hello po. Joey Bislig, shoutout sa Bislig Brothers, sa Kratos Gym, Bulacan. Maraming salamat po sa panonood. Of course, the Cebuano Assassin, Raymar Tagakanaw, shoutout sa'yo, champ. Hello, Cleven Silvestre, Randy Orbista, Miel Fardo, hindi natin alam. I think mayroon ding mga live coverage for Miel. Hindi lang po dito sa Elorde TV, ano? Pero maybe you can search for that sa Facebook, hindi lang natin sure kung saan makikita yan. But of course, we are wishing Miel Fajardo all the best as he defends his title. Ano? Sir Larry Omak, ang laban ni Harry Omak ay after nitong next fight. So the next fight is Wesley Caga of Elorde Fight Team versus Royder Bourbon from Cebu City. It's gonna be for 6 rounds. After noon, yun ang PBF Lightweight Championship ni Archel Villamor versus Harry Omak.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to acknowledge the presence of Congressman Gus Tumbunte. Palakpakan natin si Congressman Tumbunte.
Ang daming tao dito sa Elorde Sports Complex. Dito sa Elorde Ballroom, sabi ko nga, it's free. You can go here and watch the fights live. At eto na nga ang susunod na laban. Pero bago dyan, hello muna kay nag-iisang Edison Beruela sa Wadi Cup. Shoutout from Chinatown daw. Mario Ricamonte, shoutout sa'yo. Of course, Coach Ali Belonguel, shoutout sa'yo. Cleven Silvestre, shoutout daw kay Sir Bebot na nandito rin. He's in the house, our promoter. At yung Kaga fight ay ito na. Wesley Kaga versus Royder Bourbon is up next. Shoutout Ate Maribel Unabia sa'yo at sa family mo. Shoutout sa inyo dyan sa Hinguog. Of course, susunod na ang taga Hinguog. The Pride of Hinguog, Wesley Kaga. Leo Ason, shoutout. Mariel De La Cruz, shoutout sa inyo. Soon, makikita ko na po kayo. Oo, ma'am. Very, very excited to see you. Today, wala si Ninong Alvin pero show some love to Ninong Alvin na makikita nyo sa next na gig namin. Nandyan na ulit si Ninong Alvin Esgo. Ruela Kaga, ito na ang kuya mo na. Next na, up next. Mario Ricamonte, Cleven Silvestre, dati din ako nakalaban. Oo, dito sa napaka-iconic na Elorde Ballroom, ano? Pag talaga boxing, lahat halos nakalaban dito sa Elorde Ballroom. Ito yung kumbaga sentro ng boxing dito sa Metro Manila. Up next, we have Wesley Kaga of Elorde Fight Team versus Royder Bourbon. They are fighting for 6 rounds in the 115-pound division.
Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, before we give you our next spot, I'd like to Congressman Gus Tumbunte for a very special visit. Ladies and gentlemen, this next bout is scheduled for 6 rounds in the super flyweight division, presented to you by Elorde International Productions, promoter Gabriel Mendo, Elorde Jr.
Raymar Abamonga, shout out sa'yo. John Marlon Pagalpalan, shout out, watching from Binangonan, Rizal. Nagugood luck siya sa mga kasama niya sa Elorde Bebot team.
Ladies and gentlemen, the three judges Fortis Condes, Carlo Balea, Donna Gradius, and Robert Bridges. Your referee in charge of the action, Giorgio Yandel. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing first, fighting out the blue corner, wearing red and weighing 130 pounds, from Cebu City Boxing Team, Roger Borbo. And his opponent across the ring, fighting out the red corner, wearing white with red trim and weighing 150 pounds, with a professional records of two wins.
Yes, of course, sabi ni Christoph, always yan, Sir Christoph Rica Plaza. Shout out sa asawa niyang maganda na, naku ma'am, mas idol ko kayo. Maraming salamat po, always yan. O ayan ha, mamaya siya shout out ulit natin si ma'am. Ambangan Filomeno, shoutout kay Roland Tuyogon, Modesto Lorenas from Olongapo City, Raymar Abamonga from Hingog, Roland Alapormina. Nako. Oo, maraming salamat siya. Loading, loading ka talaga namin. Ano, bawal daw mag-comment dito ang mga toxic, sabi niya. Setrom Pritz, good luck kay Wesley Kaga. Ito na, ang pinaka-aabangan, sorry, ng mga taga-Hingog at taga-Cebu. We have Wesley Kaga from Hingog City and Royder Borbon from Cebu. Ito na, si Wesley Kaga na po. Yes, sir, Ma'am Vanji Maragañas. Josh Solis from Hearthstone Moniz. Yes, Ma'am Mariel De La Cruz, maraming salamat. Here we go, round one. Borbon is wearing the red trunks, ano? Itong si Wesley Kaga is wearing the white and red trunks. Chris Barrios, shout out kay Randy Suico at kay Malcolm Eagle Aiton Yakao. Eugene Noynoy, shout out sa'yo. Noel Pangantaw, shout out daw kay Crossman. Nandito lang siya sa tabi ko. Sasabihin ko yan, makakarating yan. Jab and straight to the body by Kaga. A counter hook by Borbon. So far, it's a tactical start for both these boxers. Slipping in that jab. Wesley with that hook. That wild hook to open up a closely guarded Roider Borbon. Double jab and straight to the body and hook by Kaga, but Borbon did not let that combination finish. He was able to answer with some shots of his own. A missed hook by Kaga. Kaga with a jab and shot to the body.
Mm-hmm.
There you have it. First round between Wesley Caga and Royder Lloyd Bourbon. Ano sa tingin ninyo? How did you see that round? Again, we are live here at the Elorde Sports Center for Night of Champions 32. Nasa pangalawang fight na tayo. After this, we have our double main event. The first one is for the PBF Flyweight Championship between Archel Villamor Jr. and Harry Omak. And then the second one is for the vacant youth super featherweight title between Rachel Calo and Jolniel Laurente. Here we go, round two. Wesley Caga in the white and red shorts. Ito namang si Royder Lloyd Bourbon wearing the red shorts. Some body fainting or fainting between these two boxers. Both of them are not wasting any punch. One at two by Wesley in that guard of Royder Bourbon. I like how Royder stays inside the pocket, ano? Just quick to counter. And I like how Wesley always starts off with either a jab or a double jab. And then he goes straight to the body. A jab for a jab. Quick reaction from Royder Bourbon. Kaya importante talaga yung fainting din dito sa dalawang ito eh. Kasi mabalis sila parehas. They both have quick reflexes. They both can read what's gonna happen or what their opponent's gonna throw. Kaya nakita nyo kanina, this round started with a lot of fainting, a lot of baiting. Baiting to open up because both of them have that really nice guard, have that nice defense. A jab by Bourbon to the head, jab to the body, and jab to the head by Caga. Oh, both of them were able to slip in those punches. Royder Bourbon to the body, and Wesley Caga also with a hook that got in. See, it's in those moments that they're both open that they can slip in a shot, ano? It's hard to catch the other open because they're both really defensively responsible. Last 10 seconds of this round. There you have it. End of the second round. Again, guys, this is scheduled for 6 rounds. Shout out Ace Vlog, Denison Rade. Shout out to kay Negro John Sarlo Hitos is watching from Cubangbang, Daet, Camarines Norte. Shout out daw kay Marie France. Shout out sa Marie France Ortigas. Wow, sana all makapag Marie France nga minsan, ano, para mawala ang mga excess fats natin. Kailangan ko niyan, ano, yung mga toning-toning na ganyan. Dalaw kayo sa Marie France Ortigas. Eugene Noynay, shout out. Alvin Lagumbay, shout out sa iyo, champ. Emmaline Ballard is rooting for Wesley Caga. Nilo Entero is watching us from Pampanga. Castoy Flores, shout out. Ace Vlog is watching us from Hingog City. Ang daming mga taga Hingog dito. Shout out sa lahat ng mga Hingog nun. Napakagandang city niyang Hingog. May part dyan na elevated, so malamig at apresko. Here we go, round 3. Oh, Also, I would like to take this opportunity pala, no, to promote my one of the brands that I'm promoting, Greenwich Pizza. Order na kayo, sarap. To feel G, enjoy pizza with your barkada. Again, order na kayo ng Greenwich Pizza for your barkada. Enjoy ninyo while watching Night of Champions 32. Maraming masasalap na flavors niyan at masarap din yung lasagna nila, pizza rice bakes, pizza wraps, chicken. Lahat na masasarap nandyan lang sa Greenwich. Here we go, back to the fight. Wesley with that long-range hook and jab. Both of them have good distance management. A hook straight by Bourbon that cut through. Both of them are very, very crafty. Ano? Itong si Bourbon does not, hindi siya pabaya. That's what I want to say, no? He always is defensively responsible, either with that shoulder roll or with that high guard. Hook straight and then straight by Bourbon. Kaga with that body shot and double hooks to the head. Juanito Hondante, shoutout sa'yo. Uy, nasa Ilocos Sur ka pala, no? Kamusta dyan? Ingat sa init. Balita ko, mainit daw dyan. So, guys, ha, mainit ngayong mga nakarang araw. So, hydrate tayo. Inom tayo ng tubig. Pag nararamdaman yung sobrang init na, inom na ng tubig. Ma Mariel de la Cruz. Nako, oo, kailangan namin kayo dito. Walang round girl. May round boy lang tayo today. Chris Bobby Barrios, shoutout kay Coach Bricks na nandito. Coach Bricks Flores, the legendary coach of Noy Pasing Flores, is in the house together with his wife, Ma'am Jocelyn Flores. Just a moment, ano, ng pagtigil. Itatali lang yung sapatos ni Royder Lloyd Bourbon. Gabriel Mariano, shoutout sa'yo from Bicol. Efrahim Ventura Ev, shoutout sa'yo dyan sa Laro Fitness Gym. Ang ganda naman ang pangalan ng gym nyo, Laro Fitness Gym ng Gimba Nueva Ecija. Oo nga, Champo Juanito Andante, ingat-ingat lalo sa training, ano. So, after ng papawis, inum agad ng tubig, lalo kapag light water ang iinumin, ano. And of course, I would like to mention some of our sponsors. Ito nga yung mga gloves na nakikita nyo ngayon ay Fairtex Hook Straight by, Hook Upper pala by Bourbon. And Body Shot Jab Hook Straight. Oh, that was an uppercut that got through for Royder Lloyd Bourbon. A competitive round 3 for both boxers. Isa sa mga top prospects natin in the flyweight division is watching us, Esneth Domingo. Shout out sa'yo, champ. Noel Abs Abogatal is also watching us from Hinguog. Brian Daamo watching us from Hinguog City. Emmaline Ballard. Ang daming mga taga Hinguog. Again, I would just like to say how much I loved Hinguog City. Nandyan lang ako nung December. Napakagandang town. Malinis. Malamig. And yung mga tao, very pleasant and very friendly. Here we go. Round 4. Wesley with that stiff jab. I like how Wesley always starts off with that jab, that fundamental punch that starts everything, that sets the pace, a quick left counter by Bourbon. Jab straight hook. That hook landed for Wesley Kaga. Jason Facularin, shout out sa'yo at sa Ringmaster Promotion ng Davao. Nako, napakaganda rin dyan sa Davao. Shout out sa inyo dyan. BMQ family from Hingoognon Pride. Bing Bang Gibone, shout out from Old Town. Gijo Vistal, shout out din. Shout out daw kay Peter Pagod. Again, that jab and that hook to the body by Wesley. Good rhythm, no? With that jab, no? As you can see, it's steady. It's a steady drip of jabs. Alam nyo, nakaka-distract din yan. Ha? Minsan, yung jab na yan, ang intention din is to set you off, ano? Jab and then a ripping hook to the body by Wesley. Counter right by Bourbon. Oh, he was able to land with that hook to the body. Billy Boy Acevedo, shout out. Craft Master, sabi niya, Blue Corner has good boxing skills and defense. Ken Bilita, shout out. Let's go down. Reuter Bourbon, a good uppercut that got through for Wesley. But Bourbon was also able to counter. Good body movement ano, by Reuter Bourbon. If you've watched his previous fights, he really has that good loose body movement. Ito namang si Wesley Caga is very sharp with his punching. Body shot by Bourbon. Yun nga, like I mentioned, Caga has this very controlled aggression ano, that sometimes gets him the knockout. Ano. A pivot hook by Bourbon. Light on his feet. Oh, double jab straight and hook by Caga. Reb Pags, yes, watching daw with your chikitings na si Herod and Bell. Franco, save or save, shout out Peter Pagid. Dexter Nalimo Cafe, shout out kay Peter Pagod. Both of these boxers are showing their skills in movement and in boxing. So that was a good fourth round. When I say boxing skills, ano, they really show a high aptitude for distance management. They don't waste their punches. They try as much as possible to close the distance and land. Jetty Ron, shout out daw kay Noel Baron. Si Rowella Caga, nakapatid ni Wesley Caga, sabi niya, Bonalia. So far, it's a good fight. Very competitive as we enter round 5. Sabi ni Dave Franco, Sir Dave Franco, main event mamaya, Rochelle Calo, yes. Here we go, round 5. Wesley Caga is wearing the white and the red trunks. Reuter Bourbon is wearing that predominantly red trunks, no? Gabriel Mariano, shoutout daw kay Claude Van Sese na nandito rin sa Elordi Complex. Jonas Ballard, shout out to Meller Jones. Bourbon stays low, is weaving underneath the punches of Wesley Caga to close the distance. Wesley with that upper hook. James Palarig, shout out sa iyo dyan sa Mindanao, sa Misamis Oriental. Jade Sanchez from Hingog City, shout out. Nako, share nyo pa tong video. Paramihin natin itong 185. Gawin natin 1,085. Kaya natin yan, guys. Jab by Bourbon. Hook. Jab. Double jab straight by Caga. Like I said, both of them are very crafty, ano, and all with that sound, with sound reflexes, ano, it's really hard to land the punch pag mabilis yung reflexes ng kalaban. Jetty Ron, shout out kay Peter Caron. Darwin Burdago, shout out from Hingog City. A leaping hook by Bourbon. See, Like I said, ano, oh, hook straight by Roider Bourbon, jab straight upper by Kaga that greased the gloves of Bourbon. Rafi Basa, shoutout sa'yo from Tacloban. Si Cake Galido, shoutout po daw sa galit niyang wife na si April Samantha Galido from Engineer CK Galido. Nagagalit daw kakaboxing. Baka naman kulang lang sa lambing, sir. So sa mga boxers siya na medyo nagagalit yung mga wives, onting lambing lang. No, bigyan nyo ng simpleng regalo, ganyan, masarap na meal or ng chocolate, ayan, para lumamig ang ulo. Daryl Amoncio, shoutout daw kay Champ Arnel, The Silencer, Bakunahe, Rafi Basa, shoutout sa'yo dyan sa Tacloban. Abanggon Filomeno Jr., that was a hook that landed for Wesley. Hook by Bourbon over the guard of Wesley Kaga. Rafi Basas, shout out daw sa partner niya na ayaw na daw siyang palaruin ng boxing. Nako naman mga sir, baka naman onting quality time lang ang kailangan ng mga ano natin, mga missis at mga girlfriends, ayan. Baka naman hindi naman sa ayaw niya kayong magboxing. Gusto lang nila na i-prioritize niyo sila over boxing, o di ba? Pero I'm sure love na love kayo niyang mga missis ninyo. Cyril Caminero, shout out daw from Davao del Sur. Leiron, so tip shout out sa iyo. Lana Odalaw, shout out kay Liboy Atencio. Brian Daamo, shout out kay Ashton Daamo. Jeven Villasite, isa rin sa magaling boxer na sa Trinidad. Ano, nasa La Trinidad ka ba, champ? Emmaline Ballard, shout out daw kay Glenn Ballard. Eto na, round 6 na, the 6th and the final round. So far, it's been a tactical fight. And it's a question of sino ang makakahuli kanino, no? Pareho silang crafty, pareho silang mabilis, pareho silang mabilis mag-react, pareho maganda ang depensa. Sino ang makakapag-land ng punch para makuha itong round na ito? Win Beltran, shout out po. Good luck daw sa dalawang ka-team na lalaban, si Rochelle Calo at si Archiel Villamor. Mariel De La Cruz, nako, wala daw siyang boyfriend dito sa Elorde, nako ma'am. Ay, that was a hook by Roider Bourbon. I didn't see that kasi nandun si Ref. Philip Roy, shout out sa GCAA Fortunes Boxing Team. Wow, saan po yung GCAA Fortunes? Billboy Acevedo, shout out from Bayuganon Calo. Fernando Tagpuno, isa pa sa mga top prospects natin nanonood. Shout out kay Coach Ray na nandito with Harry Omak. There you have it, that moment where everything got heated up in that ring, ano, nung nagkadikita na or na-close na yung distance between Wesley and Roider Bourbon. Shout out sa Elorde Gilmore. Relen Campesino, go the Wesley Philip Roy from Hinguog. There you have it. It's that moment that the other person counters or opens up when you capitalize on that space, on that opening, no? That overhand, nabasa ni Bourbon, he was able to evade that. Oh, that uppercut, double uppercut that got through for Wesley Kaga. Raymond De La Cruz, nakakamiss magboxing, di na pwede lumaban na operahan. Ako, sayang naman champ, no? Baka pwede pa kahit mag-training-training lang tayo kasi nakakamiss talaga yung boxing, lalo kapag parati tayo nagbaboxing dati. Again, to review, that was a good hook that got through. Bourbon answered with the uppercuts. Ma'am Mariel, hindi natin alam kung kailan ang UKC. Hula ko, baka July onwards pa po. Polly Pensanyaves, shout out sa'yo from Cebu, Mandaue. Oh, good body movement by Bourbon, but he got hit with that right hand from Wesley Kaga in that light moment Robert Agcopra, shout out. Power Fist Boxing Gym sa Molino Bacoor. Ronel De La Cruz, shout out. An overhand by Bourbon and a hook by Wesley Caga. Straight to the body by Caga. We are nearing the end of this round. Ano sa tingin nyo, mga ka-elorde? Oh, that hook got through for Wesley. Bourbon, there you have it. Hoping to land at the end of that round. And what a good fight. What a good tactical fight. Both of these boxers, excellent conditioning, excellent boxing skills, excellent body movement. Ano? All of you, I think, will agree with that. Edison Beruela, shout out sa mga pangit na babaero. Marami tayo. Naku naman. Grabe ka naman, champ Edison Beruela, no? Marami ba? Sino? Magpangalan ka nga. Magbigay ka ng mga pangalan. Hero Uy, shoutout sa'yo. Family ni Hobby, shoutout sa inyo dyan. Mga taga-Hingog, nakamag-anak ng aking asawa na si Antonio Uy. Robert Agcopra, kamusta si Idol Crossman? Nandito siya katabi ko. Sabi niya, hello daw sa inyo, sir. Sabi ni Ma'am Mariel, sana hindi draw. Anong tingin ninyo ang resulta? Ulysses Lagos, shoutout sa'yo. O, diba guys, gumagaling na ba ako sa pag-shoutout? Talagang I make it a point na babasa ko lahat ng mga shoutout nyo. Yun, isa pa sa mga magagaling nating prospects. And of course, Philippine champion Ben Ligas Jr. nanonood sa atin. Kaming taga-Hinguog. Hello sa inyo mga taga-Hinguog. Mag-shoutout ka, Crossman Uy, sa Hinguog.
Sa mga kababayan ako dyan sa Hinguog. Kumusta mong tanan dyan? Mayong hapon sa inyo. Sana namo karon sa mayong sitwasyon o panglawas. O yun na, atong pabato sa Hinguog dyan, si Wesley Caga. Yun, bago lang nahuman yung dula. Atong paminahon, kung kinsa, unsay, kinsay mo kuan sa mata sa mga judges, kung kinsay mo daw sa ilha. So, usbo na ako, chat out sa tanan dyan, taga-Hinguog, Banat Hinguog. Ato ni, let's unite.
There you have it. Ayun ha, meron pa tayong special guest na si Antonio Crossman. Uy, Flores Dominique, shout out sa Flores family watching us sa Calamba, Laguna. Nico Robin, shout out sa kaibigan niyang boxer na si Decidido Muhabal Jr. Castoy Flores, round girl lang ako ma'am. Naku, hindi round girl lang. Round girl ka. Round girl ka pala, loud and proud. Darrell Amoncio, happy birthday kay Jonathan Francisco, champ. Brian Daamo, shout out sa mayor nila na Mayor Eric Cañosa. Ito na. Ang resulta. There you have it, your winner, Wesley Caga of Hinguog City over over Ryder Lloyd Bourbon. Ako, it was such a good fight, ano. I'm proud of both of these guys. Nagpakita sila ng magandang laban. Nothing to be ashamed of. But for Ryder Lloyd Bourbon, good performance. And also, of course, ang inyong Hinguog pride, Wesley Caga has elevated his record and he continues to show us na talaga namang he has something special, ano? Mariela Gabriel Mariano, mag-shout naman tayo, Kuya Crossman. Marcelo Pasco, shout out from Gindolman, Bohol. Leo Ason, shout out sa Dohelio family. And Idol Dodong Uy, Nilo Entero, nako maraming salamat din po sa panonood. Inspirasyon namin kayo para magpakita pa ng mga maraming live na boxing fights. Basta masaya kayo, happy na rin kami. Brian Daamo, shoutout Dodong JM. Mariel De La Cruz, oo ma'am, sana makapagpa-picture kami sa inyo. Pag nandito kayo, huwag kayo mag-hesitate na lumapit sa commentating table para makapagpa-picture tayo. Cons Jumaritz, Shout out daw kay Idol Crossman. O, nandito lang siya sa tabi natin. Ronaldo Hagonay, shout out. Rafi Basas, shout out to all Filipino boxers from the Basas family. Franco Save, Grave, Wesley Abanggan, Filomeno Jr., congrats daw kay Wesley Neil Dumalag. Congrats, Wesley. Lawrence Rosas, shout out sa iyo, champ. The pride of Palawan. Setrom Yaduna Pritz, congrats daw kay Wesley Kaga. Emmeline Ballard Moreno tayo, shout out sa mga mandirigmang Pinoy. Maraming salamat daw sa Elorde sa live. Maraming salamat din sa inyo sa panonood. Fernando Tagpuno, congrats daw kay Wesley Kaga. Relene Campesenyo, Ively Zarate, Jedrick Dingkol, shout out sa Jab Street Boxing Club. Jade Sanchez, congratulations daw kay Wesley Kaga. Craftmaster Ma'am Maribel Unabia, shout out kay kapatid ng hobby ko na si Diego Uy. Shout out dong Leo Ason, good luck kay Hari O Ma'am Ak. Here we have Joe Marino Inay is entering the ring, our Philippine welterweight champion. Gabriel Mariano, nako, balik-balik lang po para sa kape ng Crossman E3. Maraming salamat sa pantagkilik. John Tabamo, shoutout dyan sa Senior Lundag Anda Bohol para daw kay Hari Omak. There you have it. Inside the ring is our Filipino champion in the welterweight division, Joe Noynay. MJ Sorita, good luck daw kay Hari Omak. Avery Ganya, shout out dyan sa Bulacan. Fernando Tagpuno, shout out daw kay Coach Tata Bitoneo.
Ang mga kalaban mo, walang iba. Hindi naman ko na singgero kasi ang pangalan Jim Sakaki. Tama ba? Tapos si Joe Moynay. Ano ba ang pwede mong masabi para sa natin mo?
Magandang hapon po sa lahat. Sana po ay masuportahan niyo po ako sa darating kong laban ngayong May 16 sa Japan. Sana po makuha natin yung titulo na WBO at OPBA. Maraming salamat po sa lahat.
There you have it. Let's support Joe Marino Inay, who is going to fight in Japan in May. There you have it. Let's all support Joe Noynay in his next fight. It's going to be a title fight, so let's wish him all the best. Martinot, shout out kay Hari Omak. Jojo Dangan, ang main event natin. Double main event tayo. Una is our PBF lightweight, light flyweight championship between Archiel Villamor Jr. and Hari Omak. Next is the vacant Philippine Youth Super Featherweight Championship between Rochelle Calo and Joniel Laurente. MJ Sorita, good luck daw kay Hari Omak. Avery Rose Ganya. Sir Archiel Villamor Sr., shout out the Demolition Team from Sydney. Thank you so much po. And shout out sa inyo dyan sa mga nanonood in Sydney, Australia. Eto na. Glenn Pellegrino, shout out sa Ligtas and Pellegrino family. Wendy Magsino, shout out Minville Valadon and Arnel Bacunahe. Ma'am Wendy is supporting Jay Laurente. Leo Ason, Fajardo na kasabay daw ni Omak. Ito na. Harry Omak is entering the ring with Coach Ray. Making his way into the ring is Archiel Villamor Jr. Sabi ni Leo Ason, Villamor versus Omak 3. Ito na ang rematch. How will this match turn out? Abangan ninyo yan. This is for the PBF Light Flyweight Championship. This is scheduled for 8 rounds. Ma'am Wendy Magsino, ayan, nandito si Arnel Bakunay, katabi natin. Ipaparating natin yung pa-shoutout mo. Martinot. Shoutout daw kay Harry Omak. Ayan na siya. Nasa loob na siya ng ring. Now, let's just briefly review their records. Harry Omak has a record of 7 wins, 3 losses, and 1 draw. Ito namang si Archiel Villamor has 6 wins and 0 loss. No draw. He's undefeated. Tignan natin kung sino ang mananalo dito sa pinaka-aabangang rematch ni Harry Omak at ni Archiel Villamor Jr. Ralph Kinesio, shoutout sa Majestic Boxing Gym. Sir Archiel Villamor Sr., shoutout Melesio Lizardo. Lana Odala, go Omak. Ito na. Alam kong ang tagal ninyo itong inantay. We have come to this moment. The PBF Light Flyweight title is on the line for this fight. Shout out Michael Hermosa. Again, share this video. Padamihin pa natin ang mga viewers natin as we witness the last two fights of the day. It's a double main event para sa Night of Champions 32. Nandito tayo lahat live sa Flash Ballroom sa Elorde Sports Complex. Again, may mga dumadating pang tao. Of course, this fight card is free for everyone to watch. So, kung hindi kayo nakadalo ngayon, follow nyo na yung Elorde TV para malaman ninyo yung mga next bouts na magaganap dito sa Elorde Sports Complex na maaari ninyong mapanood ng live. Robert Agcopra, shoutout daw kay Kuya Coach Ray Pelonia na nasa taas ng lona for Harry Omak. Enyer Genorpa, shoutout sa ELM Boxing Gym ng Malabon. shoutout sa inyo dyan, mga boxers ng Majestic Gym, ELM, Jab Street, PMI Boxing Stable. Ano pa ba yung mga na-miss ko? Kung na-miss ko yung team ninyo, Demolition Team ng Sydney. Ayan.
The rematch of the Knights of Champions 32, presented to you by Lorde International Productions, promoter Gabriel Pepo and Lorde Jr. This is 8 rounds of boxing for the Philippine Boxing Federation Light Flyweight Championship. And sponsored by Vertex, your official global sport champions, Lorde Sports and Tourism Development Corporation, and Lorde TV, Pinterest for your hand-painted bags.
Ismael Garcia, shout-out sa Sanchez Boxing Gym. Sir Wences Sumabong, shout-out sa inyo. Sir Archiel Villamor Sr., happy birthday ka kay Serio Jr. Daniega.
And Robert Bridges, and when the bell rings, your referee in charge of the action, Don Arguelles. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing first, finding out on the blue corner, wearing black with white and weighing 106 pounds with a professional record of 7 wins, 2 wins coming by way of knockout with 3 defeats and 1 bout even. From the Lorde Fight Team, Gilmore, Quezon City, for his second time as a challenger, ladies and gentlemen, Harry Omak!
There you have it, Harry Omak from Elorde, Gilmore.
His opponent across the ring, fighting at the red corner, wearing black with gold.
Sir Wences Sumabong, shout out sa inyo dyan sa Black Snake Boxing Gym ng Tagbilaran, Bohol, the home of the WBF champion, Joseph Sumabong. Chris Canyosa, happy birthday daw kay Leo Ason. There you have it, Archiel Villamor, the reigning PBF light flyweight champion, ano? He is from Elorde Boxing Gym, Santa Rita Village. Again, this is a rematch between these two warriors. Here we go! Mera Tibon, shoutout sa'yo dyan sa Mandawi. Desta Jo, church, shoutout from Muntinlupa. Patrick Ardi, shoutout daw kay Ryzen De La Fuentes. Ay, sorry, De La Fuente, sorry. 12 rounds daw sila sa heavyweight. Eto na, round 1. Sa muling pagtatapat ni Harry Omak wearing the white and black shorts versus Archiel Villamor Jr. wearing the black and yellow trunks. Nako, biglang tumahimik dito sa Elorde Ballroom, no? Tension is brewing. Everyone is at the edge of their seats. Both boxers just flicking that jab. Jabbing straight to the body by Harry Omak. Villamor counters with that double or triple jab. Jab to the midsection by, straight to the midsection by Harry Omak. A hook. After that, Villamor rushed in towards Harry Omak. Of course, our third man in the ring, referee Don Arguelles. There's a lot of backstory here. No? They faced each other previously. Oh, that was a straight that landed for Omak, but it was... Oh, there you have it. another punch that landed for Villamore. Like I said, you know, there's a backstory here. They faced each other already in the past. In 2023, December 9, 2023, Archiel Villamore Jr., of course, was the winner of that fight via KO in the third round, which that earned him, you know, the PBF light flyweight title. And this is their second time to share the ring. No, third time, sorry. This is the third time. The first time they faced each other was in 2022. The third time, the second time was in 2023. This is the third time. That round ended with an overhand. Sorry, not an overhand. An overhand by Omak. And just right at the bell, a shot got through for Archiel Villamore Jr. Again, this is the third time that Harry Omak and Archiel Villamore are facing each other. What's at stake? Of course, the PBF Light Flyweight Championship. Here we go, round eight in an eight-round bout. Of course, Harry Momak is wearing the black and white shorts. Archiel Villamore Jr. is wearing the black and yellow shorts. Our referee warning against accidental headbutts. Let's look at their stances. Ano? Archiel Villamore, of course, is the southpaw or ang kaliwete. He has this wider, more angled stance. Si Harry Omak is your orthodox boxer. Mas less narrow yung kanyang legs. He's a little more squared off. There you have it. Those moments of explosion. Anything can happen. Both of these boxers have some power, no? Behind their punches. It will actually depend on the timing. The timing of the punches. Oh, the ability to land a punch. Not too far and not too close. Henry Soldanday, shout out sa inyo dyan sa Walter Mart Bikutan. Walter Mart, the ever reliable grocery natin, ano? Mera Tibon, Go Kenshin, Archiel Villamore Jr. Omak with that counter right, Villamore with that hook, upper hook. Grabe, grabe yung sigawan dito sa venue, no? Kung naririnig nyo lang, oh! Another upper by Omak as he is retreating. But composure from Villamore Jr. Both of them are actually quick, ano? Very quick. very defensively responsible. Both of them have that stance wherein they can easily retreat and come forward. Good side-to-side movement by Villa Moore. He's able to create those angles. Last 10 seconds of the round. Is someone gonna land before the bell rings? Let's see. There you have it. Henry Soldandoy, Go Bunso, Craft Maxer. Master, kulang daw sa accuracy. Baka nagkakahulihan lang din, sir, no? Kasi minsan pag nababasa ka kaagad, talagang magre-react yung kalaban and you will not be able to land that punch because your opponent will not be there where you want him to be. So, thank you po sa insight ni Craft Master. Mahirap magkahulihan. Pareho sila na mabilis ang reflexes. Maybe some bit of setup or some feinting will help them land. Kasi pag standalone punch, mahirap makaland kasi pareho silang mabilis eh. Mabilis ang reflexes. No Pax Esoy, shout out from Lapu-Lapu City. Here we go, round three. Again, fencing with that jab. Omak trying to land something to the midsection, but Villa Moore is quick to retreat. A jab by Omak. Villa Moore was able to step back. That's what I'm saying, ano, yung jab, pareho naman silang nag-jab, pero yun na nga, ano, iba-iba yung gamit ng jab. It's one way that you can elicit a reaction. It's one way that you can find your range. It's also one way of disrupting the rhythm of your opponent. A counter upper that slightly grazed Villa Moore right there. Villa Moore moving forward, was able to move at an angle. Double straight by Villa Moore. An overhand by Omak. A jab by Villa Moore over that guard. Trying to pull with that jab. He was quick to move at an angle to evade that punch from Ari Omak. Counter upper by Omak. There are so many things we can learn in this fight, ano? As you can see, both of them are quick. Both of them are using that jab. But we are yet to see, ano, a significant moment wherein one person lands a significant shot against the other. Pareho nga kasi silang mabilis. Pareho silang defensively responsible. It's very rare that you find them careless, ano? Villa Moore pawing with that jab, trying to obstruct the vision of Omak with that pawing jab. Villa Moore Jr. moves to the right. Pause with that jab. Omak attempts to land that overhand. Oop, that was a straight that landed for Villa Moore. How will Omak respond to the movement of Villa Moore? Oh, that hook up top actually landed for Ari Omak at the end of that round. So interesting, ano, the movement, the quickness of Archel Villa Moore versus the pinpoint accuracy of the counter of Ari Omak. Again, please share this video para mas marami pa tayong mag-enjoy sa panonood. Again, I would like to invite everyone to like Elorde TV para malaman din nyo rin ano, kung ano yung mga susunod na laban na pwede ninyong mapanood. Please help us attain our follower goal. Help us to gain more followers up to 50,000. Yan ang goal natin. Sa Muldeherni, more boxing promoter, everyone. Ma'am Marielle De La Cruz, may single ba sa Elorde? Aba ma'am, dumalaw ka na dito para malaman natin, hindi ba? Sabi ni Craftmaster, Villamar took over that round. Kayo, yung mga iba, what is your opinion of that previous round as we enter round 4? Harry Omak is wearing that black and white trunks and itong si Villamar Jr. is wearing the black and yellow trunks. Paolo Prado, shoutout daw kay Ray Peña. Shoutout sa Muelde, sa Mulde Herni from Tarlac City. Right now, it's beginning to be a fight of who lands with more accuracy, no? Right now, what Archel Villamor is, he's limiting no the ability of Omak to land by creating different angles after he lands a punch. Now, it's Omak's It's his job to cut the ring to make it impossible for Villamor. Oh! Uppercut for Omak right there. Villamor stays light on his feet. Feints. Oh, another counter upper. Dalawang counter upper for Villamor. Another counter upper. Oh, Harry Omak. Oh, there you have it. Wow. Like I said, it's the accuracy that will set. There you have it. Beautiful uppercuts by Archiel Villamor. The timing, the accuracy of Archiel Villamor. Up until this point, the bout was very competitive, but beautiful timing from the champion as he retains the PBF light flyweight title. Sabi nga natin, kahit sinong malakas pag tinamaan talaga sa bodega, no? And actually, it is compounded when you move towards the punch. Mas lalo pa. So really, the counter uppers, it's right when you're moving forward. That's the body shot that hurts the most. There you have it. Let's wait for the official announcement from none other than the voice of Philippine boxing, Sir Jaime Villanera. Sabi nga ni Craft Master Bodega daw, tama yan. Walang matibay pag talagang diretso sa bodega yung tama and then hindi ka nakapaghanda or you are walking into that punch. The power of that punch compounds. And yun na nga, there we have it. A knockout win for Archiel Villamor Jr. Sir Archiel Villamor Sr. must be very proud at ang kanyang mga team at kaibigan dyan sa Sydney, Australia. Reb Pags, congrats daw kay Archiel Villamor. A round 4 knockout win. This concludes the trilogy between these two boxers, no? Like I said earlier, ito ang ikatlong pagkakataon na sila ay nagtapat.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Donald Grudias stops the fight at 2 minutes and 10 seconds of round number 4, winner by KO victory. And still, the Philippine Boxing Federation light flyweight champion, Archel Villamor.
There you have it, Archel Villamor Jr. is still the PBF light flyweight champion, and of course, no shame and no reason to be ashamed for Harry Omak. He put up a good fight. And kahit anong mangyari, ano, ang pangalan ng Ilorde pa rin ang nagkampyon. Both of them are from different Ilorde gyms, actually. Archel Villamor from St. Rita, Ilorde St. Rita, and Harry Omak from Ilorde Gilmore. Dumagit Lukasan, congrats daw kay Archel Villamor. Henry Sol Dandoy, congrats bunso. Eto na ang pangalawa sa ating double main event. This is for the vacant Philippine Youth Super Featherweight title. Rachel Calo of Ilorde, Santa Rita versus Choniel Laurente of Ilorde Fight Team. Meranoy Night Tibon, yes, congrats daw kay Archiel. Dumagit Lukasan, congrats daw. Again, I would like to take this opportunity to invite everyone, of course, na tikman ng Greenwich Pizza. Favorite ko natin dyan, of course, yung glazed honey with spinach and cheese. And of course, lasagna. And of course, yung roast beef with cream cheese. Paborito din natin yan. Pizza bakes, roast beef na pizza bakes. Masarap din yan. Yun. Especially para sa mga mahilig sa pizza. Try nyo na yung Greenwich. Yan ang paboritong pagkain ng ating barkada. And like I said, Greenwich Pizza. And more, lasagna, rice bakes, pizza wraps, chicken, potato waves. Sarap to feel G talaga with all of those choices. Talaga namang magiging sulit ang bonding ninyong barkada pag Greenwich ang inyong in order. Here at the Ilorde Sports Center. This is for the main event natin. This is for the vacant Philippine Youth Super Featherweight title. Rachel Calo versus Choniel Laurente. Luis Sabas, shoutout daw kay Ronnie Baldonado. Hello Luis, kamusta kayo dyan sa Japan? Namimiss na kayo ng Ilorde family ninyo. Suz Likot, congrats daw kay Champ Archel Villamor Jr. Lana Odala, Congratulations kay Archiel Villamor. Sir Archiel Villamor Sr., congratulations daw sa kanyang anak na si Archiel Villamor Jr., Craftmaster Elorde Promotion for Young Filipino Boxers, definitely, no? We always need promotions like this, yung nagbibigay ng break sa ating mga up-and-coming boxers. Dito natin kasi talaga makikita yung ating mga future champions, ano? Bago magkaroon ng world champion, syempre nagsisimula yan lahat dun sa national level, ano? National and regional championship level. Dumagit Lucasan is watching us from Japan. Ang galing naman daw ni Villamor Jr. Yes, definitely that fight was really something else that concluded the trilogy between Harry Omak and Archiel Villamor Sr. Sorry, Jr. Here we go, ang pinaka-aabangan nating lahat na main event.
It's time for your Knights of Champions main event of the evening for the 32 edition. Presented to you by Elorde International Productions, promoter Gabriel Bebo, Elorde Jr. This is 8 rounds of boxing for the Philippine Breakout Youth Super Featherweight.
Sabi ni Sir Ronald Medes, congratulations daw kay Mark Justin Mendez, Champion Regional Meet and Road to Palarong Pambansa 2024. Conlin Viray, Irish Lucero, shout out. Junrey Nokiao, watching us from Masbate. Merlin Luis, congrats daw sa kanyang mahal na si Archiel Villamor Jr. Sinoy Banaria, shout out sa inyo dyan sa San Juan, Batangas. Shoutout sa ating bagong panalo at bagong kampiyon, Champ Albert Francisco. Shoutout sa iyo, Champ.
Coming by way of knockout, one defeat. He helps fighting out of the Elorde Boxing Gym. Of South Box, Las Piñas City. Ladies and gentlemen, Junyel La. And his opponent across the ring, fighting out of the red corner, wearing black with orange trim, also weighing 129 pounds, with a professional record of 6 wins, 3 wins, coming by way of knockout, 1 defeat. He helps from Bayugan Agusan Dansur. Tonight, he represents a learned boxing game of St. Rita Parañaque City. Ladies and gentlemen, Rochelle.
Here we go. Of course, our title. Nakita niyo naman yung vacant Philippine Youth Super Featherweight title na hawak ng ating GAB chairman, si Chairman Attorney Richard Clarin. Of course, our boxing division head, Miss Jackie Cacho, is also inside the ring. Of course, with our promoter, Sir Bebot Elorde. Ito na ang pinaka-iintay ninyo. Who will emerge as the champion today? Is it Rochelle Calo from Elorde Boxing Gym, St. Rita, or Joniel Laurente from Elorde South Box? Like we said, this is the youth title, ano? So, ibig sabihin, both of these boxers are below 25. Third man in the ring, referee Carlo Baluyot. Ballistic jabs by both boxers to start off this round. Again, the title on the line today is the vacant Philippine Youth Super Featherweight title. Both of these boxers are some of your top boxers here in the Philippines. Itong si Joniel Laurente is number 7 right now in the super featherweight ranking in the Philippines. Ito namang si Rochelle Calo is number 10 in the Philippines. Very close. They are both fighting to be the youth Philippine champion tonight. Oh, there you have it. Nothing but sharp punches by both boxers. Itong super featherweight division is another exciting division. Maraming nag-emerge na magagaling dito sa division na to. And it's something that will possibly be a division where we can have another world champion. So it's good to see these young fighters fight for the belt, hone their skills. Oh, there you have it. Just simultaneous punches. Itong dalawang boxers na to, both have speed, they both have power, they are both balanced, they both have that knockout power. Shout out daw kay Lucas Bendima from Luis Sabas. Roel Lucero, shout out sa'yo dyan sa Cebu. Luis Sabas is rooting for Joniel Laurente. I-type niyo sa comment section, who are you rooting for? Rochelle Calo of Elorde St. Rita or Joniel Laurente? Joshua De La Cruz is rooting for J.L. Laurente. Frieza Sailun, shout out from SG or Singapore ba yan? Hindi po sa 4th Estate to, Sir John Pokita. Ito ay sa tabi ng 4th Estate sa Elorde Sports Complex, Elorde Ballroom. There you have it. Final 10 seconds of the first round. This is scheduled for 8 rounds. There you have it. Sir Robert Abcopra, shout out kay Coach Toto Laurente daw. Yes, para namang hindi tayo nasa isang kwarto lamang, Sir Chris Rica Plaza, shout out sa'yo. Congratulations sa iyong pagko-corner kanina. Yevi, shout out daw sa Agudo family from Jensan. Vanjo Rosales, shout out. Alex Apilado, congrats daw sa Villamor family. again, some of the personalities here in Elorde Ballroom, you have Joe Noynay, the Philippine champion. Here we go, round two. Rochelle Calo is wearing the black and yellow trunks. Si Joniel Laurente wearing the white and red trunks. Sino Ibanaria, binabati daw niya yung mga mahilig sa boxing. Jeremy Calibo from South Cotabato. Gonzales Roberto, shout out sa iyo, champ. Nako, kamusta ka na? Namimiss mo ba ang boxing? June Beltran from Hinguog. Oh, sharp. Straight by Laurente, body shot by Calo. Oh, another body shot by Rochelle Calo. Laurente trying to pierce the guard of Calo with that straight. Like I said, both of them have that jab to hurt and to stop the opponent from their tracks, ano? Angel Ramos watching from Rome, Italy. June Beltran. I like how both of them are comfortable moving forward and retreating, no? As you can see, let's look at their stances. Itong si Rochelle Calo ay ang inyong orthodox boxer. He's right-handed. Itong si Joniel Laurente is the southpaw. Both of them are using that jab beautifully. Coach Ruel Dorano, shout-out po sa inyo. Diyan sa Australia. Jab and straight right through the guard by Laurente. Calo is unfazed. Answers with a jab. Double jab upper. That was a short hook that landed for Calo, but Laurente explodes with that combination. Hooks from Laurente, moves to an angle for that upper. Another jab that landed for Laurente, but Calo answers with a stiff jab of his own. Hook straight, a hook by Laurente. Calo answers with an uppercut, moving at an angle. Ramel Depas, shout out sa'yo. Nuvali Laguna, security guard. Abe Abdullah, shout out from South Cotabato. Masterful use of jab by both boxers. Laurente capitalized on that, ano, by setting up his combinations through that jab or that hook. There you have it. End of a round two. Dexter Sagin, shout out daw kay Annalyn Tabalan. Shout out ulit sa family ni Chris Rica Plaza, kay Mrs. Rica Plaza at sa kanilang daughter, tama ba? Dennis Esmero, shout out from Olongapo City, watching daw for Jay Laurente. Sa mga nanonood, type ninyo, who are you rooting for? Is it Jay Laurente or Rochelle Calo? Both of them are highly ranked in the Philippines. Laurente is number 7 in the Philippine ranking. Calo is number 10. There you have it. Round 3. There you have it. Beautiful jabbing by both boxers. Laurente was able to land that uppercut and that hook. Natalia Acuna, shout out. Fidel Lahasa, shout out din. Craftmaster, shout out sa mga followers daw ng Craftmaster. Jab, jab, body by Laurente. Calo with that high guard, countered with that upper. another straight, double straights for J.L. Laurente. He pivots with that hook. Rochelle Calo paused with that jab but was met with hooks by Laurente. Yen Quintana, shoutout sa inyo dyan sa Duhak family and Kalamba family. Body shot by Rochelle Calo. Oh, a straight that landed right through the guard by J.L. Laurente. Another straight. 1-2 by J.L. Jab by Calo. Hook straight and straight to the body by Laurente. Right now, Laurente has that steady rhythm of jab, jab, and three-punch combinations. Ano? He tries to either land that straight up top and then moves at an angle and then answers with jabs. Ito namang si Calo is trying to time that ripping body hook. Again, the title on the line for today is the vacant Philippine Youth Super Featherweight title. Tama kayo, youth ang narinig ninyo. So pareho dito sa boxers natin. I think JL is 22, Rochelle Calo, I'm not sure, but definitely he's below 25 dahil yung youth title ay para lamang sa mga 25 and below. Oh, that was a quick upper by Calo. JL with triple hooks and then an uppercut up in the middle of that guard. He's trying to pierce that guard. Jab up. Both of them are masterful at using that jab. It's just that who capitalizes on that jab that will have an edge here. Yen Kalamba na taga Bayugan City. Hindi ko nabasa na taga Bayugan ka pala. Natalio Acuna from Alfonso Cavite. Fidela Hasa, shoutout daw kay Chuchu. Albert Almonte, shout out kay Efren Dai Duyan from Taguig. Again, you are watching the last bout of the day. This is the main event of Night of Champions 32. This is for the vacant Philippine Youth Super Featherweight title. Again, iniimbitahan ko kayong lahat na i-like at i-follow ang Elorde TV dahil saan pa kayo makakapanood ng libreng boxing dito lamang sa Elorde TV. This is Rica Baby Dynamite Aquino. This is round 4. Rochelle Calo in the black and orange trunks. Joniel Laurente in the white and red trunks. A straight that landed for JL. Calo tries to parry that jab, but Laurente straight still got through. Our third man in the ring, referee Carlo Baluyot. Kanina naman si referee Don Argueles, ang ating dynamic duo for today ng mga referees. Shout out to Coach Up. Prilito Agcopra, maraming salamat sa inyo. Si Crossman nandito lang. Anton Maglinte, shout out sa iyo. Good luck daw kay JL Laurente. Alam mo, Anton, yung gumawa ng kukuko ng isang araw ay kapitbahay mo daw. Sa 4th Estate siya. Isa siyang manikurista. At crush ka daw niya. Sus Likot, shout out. Double jab straight for Rochelle Calo. That landed flush. JL with that double hooks and uppercut. The mixed section. Dave Franco, kumbati daw kay Kuya Calo. Again, like I said, both of these boxers are highly rated in the Philippines. Number 7, Laurente versus number 10, Calo. Sila ang future natin. Oh, there you have it. A straight that landed for Laurente. That rear hand keeps on landing through that guard. But Calo is unfazed. He keeps moving forward with a tight guard. Anes Alupag, shout out sa iyo dyan sa Cebu, Anton Maglinten ako, hindi ko na alam ang pangalan, pero yun nga, nasa 4th estate siya ngayon at nagtatrabaho sa isa sa parlor doon. An uppercut that got through for Carlo, 1-2 by Laurente. Ooh, another straight that landed. You know, what I like about these two boxers also is how they use their head movement to launch counters. No, it's very important also for fights as dynamic as this to use your body and your head movement to launch a counter attack. Oh, there you have it. That rare hand of JL landed on Carlo. Rochelle answers with a body shot. He was stunned for a moment right there. End of the round. Wow. What an exciting round four. Just when it was about to end, that's where we saw that firefight between Rochelle Carlo and Jonelle Laurente. Castoy Flores, Paasa Tanan Bay, ma'am. Ano yun? John Jason Pokita. Here we go, round five. Oh, an uppercut got through for Carlo. JL moving at an angle and landing that straight. So may tanong kanina, no? I forgot who that question was from. Sino ang number one daw sa Pilipinas in the super featherweight division? No other than Mark Magsayo. Number two is Charlie Suarez. Number three is Virgel Vitor. Number four is John Dato. Number five is Marvin Esquerdo. Number six, Ian Sampan. Number seven, Jonelle Laurente. Oh, a hook! Uppercut landed for Rochelle Carlo right there. Oh, another hook that landed for Carlo. JL answers with an upper and a hook. Is this a firefight or what? Craftmaster, I think, oo, meron silang blood relation ni Christian Pete Laurente. I will clarify that later. Anton Maglinte, shout out daw sa assistant ni Coach Toto na si Minville Valadon. O Tom Raymark, shout out. AC Cordova, go Kuya JL. Straight to the body, landed by JL. A jab landed again on the head of Carlo. Carlo answered with that rare hand. Oh, that uppercut got through for JL Laurente. You know, whenever JL moves at an angle, he's able to land those unexpected short uppers and those hooks, you know. But Carlo is devastating also with that straight. When that straight lands on the head, it's really something. Opo, tapos na po si Harry Omak, Sir JR Omak. Hindi man siya pinalad sa kanyang laban kay Archel Villamor Jr. Ay maganda naman ang naging laban nila. Oh, another counter straight by Laurente to end that round. Shout out Jules Victoriano, na teammate ni J.L. Laurente from Elorde South Box. Again, the title on the line tonight is the vacant Philippine Youth Super Featherweight title, ano? Youth title because both of these boxers are below 25. Here we go, round six. O nga, Coach Ruel, no, natalo si Miel Fajardo, but still, I know he's gonna come back stronger, even if he lost that OPBF belt. The fact that he fought in a foreign territory, congratulations pa rin. And congrats to the new champion. Daniele Coraz, shout out sa'yo, at kay Romar Ponchon. Let's see how the rhythm will change right now, no? Right now, they're fencing with that jab. They're trying to use tactical retreats, no? Hook up top from JL. Kahlo tries to feint with a jab to the body. An uppercut that landed for Rochelle Kahlo. Lixer Painko, shout out po sa inyo dyan sa Hiraya Combat Sports, Los Baños, Laguna. Kawayan Sports TV, shout out sa inyo. Jail moves to the right to land that upper. Kahlo answers with that jab. Nagkasabayan sila ng hook doon, ano? Ronilo Mirambel, shoutout sa'yo dyan sa Marinduque. Maraming salamat sa mga Pilipinong nanonood ngayon sa iba-ibang parte ng Pilipinas. Also overseas, I know you guys took the time to watch our event today. Maraming salamat po sa inyo. Wendell Magsino, shoutout kay Jules Victoriano at mga idol ng South Box. Sabi ni Coach Arizala, lamang daw ang Pinoy dito. Sa tingin ko rin, Coach, ano? At sigurado rin ako na ang mananalo ng youth title natin ngayon ay Pilipino. Again, you are watching Rochelle Kahlo in the black and orange trunks. Si JL Laurente wearing the white and red trunks. I would like to mention also Be Athletic, one of the supporters of Elorde Fight Team. Navsky Greg, oo, lamang na lamang talaga ang Pinoy. RG Gadores, shout out. Both of them are trying to soften up each other's guards, ano. Talagang no backing out from both boxers. Both of them are trying to draw each other into the open. There you have it. End of round six. Coach Ruel Durano, balik na po si Anton sa training pero may injury pa po siya kaya hindi pa po niya ginagalaw yung kanan niyang kamay. Pero nagko-conditioning po siya and yung left hand lang po niya ang ginagamit niya. A competitive fight thus far. Let's see what's gonna happen on round seven, the penultimate round. We have eight rounds for this vacant Philippine Youth Super Featherweight Championship. Again, shout out sa aking partner sa Recarbonation, Ninong Alvin Esgo, na wala siya ngayon dito. Pero sa susunod na event, I'm sure nandiyan na si Ninong Alvin ninyo. Here we go, round 7. Jail starts with a jab to the body and a jab to the head. Moving again to the right. Oh, that was a hook that landed for Kalo. Shoutout sa'yo, Arvin Magramo. Enoch Jasper, shoutout from Esperanza, San Agustin. Agusan del Sur. Sorry na, na duduling na tayo. Good combination. Mid pivoting by Junior Laurente. Yes po, coach. Kita tayo pag-uwi. Coach Durano, double jab by Kalo. Hook upper by Rochelle Kalo. Ryzen De La Fuente ang nanalo sa co-main event natin. I see Archiel Villamor Jr. Renan Inal, shoutout sa'yo dyan sa Jensan. Stiff jab by Laurente, followed by a straight, another jab. Coach Titing Laurente, shout out po sa inyo. Kinuha yata ng batang kaya po si Ninong Alvin. Oo nga, no? Hingi tayo ng balato dyan, Coach Bong. No? Sana hindi tayo makalimutan ni Ninong Alvin pag artista na siya. Shout out daw kay Wesley Caga at Rochelle Kalo from Enoch Vargas, Gilsano, Jasper. JL again, continuing to circle to the right, lands that straight. Oh, there you have it. A little bit of a exchange right there in which Laurente was successful in landing. Pukoy Abila, shout out Prinsesang Pukoy ng Albay Boxing Team. I love you all. Nako, maraming salamat Prinsesang Pukoy sa panonood. 1-2 that landed. JL has that ability to land that 1-2 even when he's moving, ano. Ito namang si Kalo. What I like about Kalo is how ballistic his straight is, ano, and if he's able to land that, it's dangerous also. Che Carpio, shout out sa boss niya na si Ma'am Graciel Elorde, Ate Arlene and Kuya Bebot Elorde. Of course, Sir Bebot Gabriel Elorde is our promoter today. David Franco, shout out from Bayugan City. Champ Arvin Magramo, shout out sa aking favorite na chikiting na si Sky. Skyler Smith Magramo. Ito na, last and final round in our main event today. Who will take home the vacant Philippine Youth Super Featherweight Championship? In the house also is Ma'am Kukoy Elorde, our boss in Elorde South Box, and of course, Fairtex Philippines. Sir Bebot Elorde is also in the house. I would like to also mention that our chairman, GAB chairman, Attorney Richard Clarin is in the house, as well as Boxing Division Head, Ma'am Jackie Castro is also in the house. Here we go, last and final round.
Rante Lazar.
This round starts the same way, a fencing of jabs. Rochelle Kalo a little more aggressive at the start of this round. Moves in with that upper. JL answers with a jab and a pivot hook. Lands that straight. Oh, that upper and straight also landed from JL. Kalo with that head movement to evade those punches. A missed hook by Kalo, but he was able to land that upper on the gloves of JL. Rose Sese, shout out from Surigao City. Again, maraming salamat sa mga nanonood. Please follow Elorde TV. Oh, upper left and right upper landed by JL, pero naka-land din itong si Rochelle Calo at that exchange, ano? A straight and a jab. That jab is always a precursor to a bombardment of straight for Laurente. But a hook lands for Calo. Our referee, Carlo Baluyat, warns against accidental headbutts, which is more common, ano, when you see southpaw and orthodox matchups. Mariel de la Cruz, shout out daw kay Alizer Trinidad na pinaka-idol niya. Calo moves the fight to the middle of the ring. Receives a straight from Laurente. Kyle Asuncion, shout out from Brody Jim, Barangay San Isidro, Montalban. Another stiff jab landed by Laurente. Again, circling to the right is Laurente with that hook. Calo answers with a probing jab. Double jab by Laurente. Wasn't able to capitalize on that. Wasn't able to follow up on that punch. An uppercut was attempted by Calo. Ooh, 1-2 by JL Laurente. So, i-type niyo sa comment section, who do you think will bring home the vacant Philippine Youth Super Featherweight title? Sabi ni Craftmaster, he thinks JL will win this. Shout out Yevi. Last 10 seconds. Who do you think will emerge as the winner of today's main event? Again, you are watching Night of Champions 32. And that concludes the fight between Joniel Laurente from Elorde South Box and Rochelle Calo from Elorde Santa Rita. Again, maraming salamat po sa panonood. Mabuhay po kayong lahat. Mabuhay ang lahat ng taga-subaybay ng Philippine Boxing. Again, like and follow Elorde TV. It's Ki Tumbaga thinks that JL will win this fight. Arvin Magramo, Ramonito Pikit also thinks that JL will win. Sino sa tingin nyo ang panalo dito sa laban na ito? Kung sino man ang manalo dyan? Ang magwawagi, sure ako na galing sa isang Elorde gym because JL Laurente is from Elorde South Box while ito namang si Rochelle Calo is from Elorde St. Rita. Here we go, our chairman, GAB chairman, Attorney Richard Clarin with our Philippine Youth Belt along with Miss Jackie Cacho, our boxing division head. Renan, Ina, yes, congrats both fighters. Oo, ang gandang laban. This is if this is a glimpse of what the super featherweight division holds for us in the future, then we are positive that we are going to have another world champion. Delmar Pelio thinks that JL Laurente will win. Jevia, congrats daw kay JL. Let's see the official decision. Again, this is Rica Baby Dynamite Aquino ang inyong commentator today. Wala si Ninong Alvin Esgo. Pero sa susunod na gig namin for sure, nandyan na ulit ang other half ng Recalvination. Robin Langres, shoutout champ sa'yo dyan sa Thailand. Sabi ni Pukoy Ignacio Abila, mukhang Pinoy daw mananalo. Nako, sure tayo dyan. Again, please like my socials, Baby Dynamite Sports. Please support Greenwich also and support Elorde TV.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 8 rounds of boxing, we go to the scorecards. And here are the scores of the 3 judges. Jojo Lianel scores about 78-74. Donald Guerrias scores about 80-72. And Robert Bridges finds 80-72. To the winner by unanimous decision. And now
There you have it. Your winner, Joniel Laurente of Elorde South Box, is the new Philippine Youth Super Featherweight Champion. Of course, great work by Rochelle Calo. It's just that today, tonight, is JL's night. There you have it, your new GAB champion. Again, maraming salamat sa mga nanood ng Night of Champions 32. Follow niyo po ang Elorde TV para malaman ninyo kung kailan ang susunod nating live na pa-boxing dito sa Elorde. Ito po si Rica, Baby Dynamite Aquino, in behalf of my partner, Alvin Esgo of Real Fight PH. Maraming salamat from Recalvination and of course, from your Elorde family. Ingat kayo, mga ka-Elorde, and kita-kits sa susunod na event.